to when they say jive turkey.
I'm not getting into it.
They're referring to you. That's
they're talking about you.
Yeah, I appreciate y'all coming out to Live from Akron, and give it up for Hendoh, Alexander Henderson. He's here. He's on the panel. He's ready for action.
Yeah.
He's looking for trouble. And we got tonight's featured musical guest. He's back. He's a regular. He's a man of commitment. And his name is Jack Windsor. There he is right there. And for now, he's on the panel.
Not the host.
But he'll be doing some music here before we're done today, for sure. This is Live from Akron, and you got 2 minutes, and then we talk about it. That's the whole thing. Bring your talent to the stage, you know. And we're singer-songwriters and we're comedians, but we also we want to see people outside of that realm, you know. So basically, it's like a talent show. And come on down here to Highland Square, get on the stage, and see what you got. And maybe you can walk away with a sample of deodorant.
Maybe a gig somewhere.
At least deodorant out here today. This is getting hot.
I got some, actually.
This is like right now.
I bought it from you.
Thank you, Jack. I know, Jack's on board. But yeah, Victory Pose is a sponsor, and that's my little side hustle. I make the body care products at home here in Akron, Ohio. So we do have free samples, actually. And, if anybody, knocks it out of the park, they might even get a bar of soap. So,
hey, man. Ooh. It was all worth it after all.
It's great deodorant. Trust me, I use it every day. So. Actually, every 3 days. That's how good it is.
Superior craftsmanship.
Yeah. Just yeah, I forget to put deodorant on. I'm like, oh shit, I use that fucking Victory Pose. I'm good. Yeah.
Thank you for the testimonial. You know, it, coming from somebody who. No, he was a preacher back in the day, right? I mean.
Yeah, it's kind of sort of.
So. There's no better way to get a testimonial than from an OG, a preacher man.
Yeah.
Preaching the gospel.
That's right. I won't never lie.
So yeah, we got a few performers lined up, and it's pretty exciting. We got Kyle Robert Brace, also known as Cover Boy. He showed up. He's in the house. And we have Chelsea in the house. We have Andrew Burge.
Andrew Burge, yeah.
Burge, yes. Andrew Burge is in the house, and he's a busy comedian out there, so we got a nice mix of talent here in the room tonight. And we're super stoked. So we got our first performer up here, and he's a wild one. he's a hill person.
Like he walked right out of that Bob Ross video on TV. Right down the mountain, come on up.
Yeah, he's a man who knows his way around a stage, and he knows his way around a river, and some creeks, some hollers.
Oh yeah.
And his name is Morgan. Morgan John Chase, everybody. So give it up. He's gonna do 2 minutes for us. All right. Give us something good. You got us 2 minutes?
Gotcha. What can I do all on my own? It's got to be more than just working through this mess. I just want to
myself. I can't do it, no, not all alone. To lift myself up out of this hell, I just need to get away. Gummo.
Gummo? What's that?
Yeah, sounds good. That movie?
No, it sounds awesome.
It's a cult classic.
Yeah. Okay.
You know.
Because my nickname's Jomo. Or Mojo. Yeah, you flipped it around.
Yeah.
Yeah. But Gummo, I've never heard of that one.
And, no, you're just a lovable man. You got a lovable quality about you, dude. And you really had my attention the whole time with that, the pitch or no pitch.
Yes. Thank you so much, man.
So what's your ideal setting to play in? Do you go to jams? What style? Bluegrass?
Sidewalk, traffic.
Busker.
Yeah, I like to play. No, I was playing a lot of open mics since I moved to Ohio, like 5 or 6 years ago. And then I realized if you go out on the street, play on the street to like either cars driving by or there's like nobody out there, you really get a little more comfortable with your performance.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you can let your voice open up a little more.
Yeah.
So that really helps. But I guess I'm trying to get back into the open mic thing. No, I go to one in Canton. It's Mudswigs, and then there's one at George's too, same night on Tuesday. So that's my little, and then this, of course, try to make it to this as much as possible.
Yeah, I could bust his balls because, I mean, he's my busking buddy. We actually busk together.
Yeah.
And so.
By the way, which was a sweet session across the street the other day. Yeah.
Oh, Highland Square. It's always
some
good.
Steps across the street there?
Pretty much. Yeah. Something like that, yeah. It was awesome. But yeah, I'm from West Virginia, buddy.
Yes, sir. A hill person. Authentic.
Yeah, I miss my mountains. But you know, it's not that far with all these interstates and roads. It's good to get away from home and then go home to get away from this home. So it's kind of nice, you know?
Yeah.
I live like two lives, kind of. But it's all one life, you know?
I just have a question about that song. You know, you were like, you know, did you write that at a music festival under the influence of anything?
That's probably one of my most soberest influenced songs ever, probably.
Okay.
It's after I like got out of jail and was just like, couldn't see my kid much. And I was wanting to be free, but it just sure as hell didn't feel like I was ever going to be free. Again, like I had it. And it was like having the kid and the baby and the baby mom, like all the responsibility, the new life, you know, the new changes that it set in. I was feeling pretty blue, I guess. I mean, I feel like it sounds that way. Kind of a little depressing, but that stuff's good every once in a while, you know? It'll cool you down.
It came off positive to me. And Yeah, it was kind of awesome. So you were locked up for a while. Was it drugs or?
No. Just trying to talk to the baby mama and her not wanting to.
Yeah. Baby mama drama.
Yeah, man. I thought for sure they'd just like let me in if I tried like the sixth time. They just like open up and have pancakes and coffee and tea waiting and be like, "What's going on, Morgan?" And I'd be like, "Oh, start crying." But no, it didn't really work out like that. I got the comedian laughing over here, so something's good about this story.
Baby mama drama.
Yeah.
Are things all good?
Oh yeah, they're really great right now. Honestly, like it's always a fluctuating work in progress, but things are super busy.
Yeah, I mean you kind of.
Yeah, we don't speak much. No, we're good. What?
I say you kind of beam positivity. So.
That's honestly one of the most challenging places. I find it shine positivity is with those interactions and those relationships that are really hurtful or troubled, hard for you to deal with. That's when it's most hard to be yourself. Cause like I can like go out to a stranger and like be myself and like whatever, but like somebody like that, it's like it's a really interesting dynamic.
Yeah, you got to change up your, you know, demeanor and people around you too. I mean, you have to know how to keep those negative energy type people from around you. You know, that's going to bring you down too. So I get it, man. I like your demeanor. I think it's came off great, like over the rainbow type great, you know what I mean? So yeah, keep going what you're doing, brother. And, you know, I like it.
Yeah, no, it's great stuff. I was busting little balls, but I really did like it.
Well, that's your job.
Trying to get better at it.
You're good.
But, yeah, dude. Yeah, definitely keep at it, man. That was authentic, man. Coming from a real spot, you know, and I could hear that.
How old are you?
34. Yeah. I think that's what I was going to say about what you said, Hendoh, is like sometimes you blame other people because you feel victimized by whatever happened. But the second you can, like, get that balance back to middle and push it to where like it doesn't matter what they did or what happened, that if you can be positive in the presence of them no matter where they're at, then you kind of push it back to where it needs to go. And that's
about your years.
Exactly. You realize you are the one that's like half the problem.
The hardest thing about doing all of that is being yourself. But the hardest thing about doing all that is being yourself while they're realizing they have to change themselves to be that way.
But where did you come from?
My mom, hey.
Yo, where did you come from?
I came from my mom and dad.
Yeah, I mean, we all, well, I came from my mom.
But you didn't all come from my mom and dad, or we were brothers and sisters.
And that would be West Virginia type.
Hey. Just because he got the hat don't mean he...
No, he's from West Virginia.
I believe it. The west side of West Virginia.
You just missed that. You missed the whole way of the performance. Yeah. That's good idea stuff, man. I appreciate it.
Yeah. I appreciate you all. We are all brothers from other layers.
Yeah, give it up for Morgan, everybody.
Thanks for coming out, man.
Thanks for having me.
Then,
Everyone has smelled themselves at some point in their life and have been displeased or found something unpleasant there. Well, that's never going to happen again. And when you have control over how you smell, you have control over how you feel. Victory Pose definitely solves that problem. So Victory Pose is premium body care in a sustainable package. You're not going to miss a connection, you know, a networking opportunity. You're not going to miss finding a lover. You're not going to miss, you know, finding the job. I mean, you can't, let's face it, you can't really function in life if you're walking around here like a caveman, you know, smelling from the armpits. So we're so shockingly effective that when you compare us to products like Tom's of Maine, you'll find us to be 2 to 3 times more effective, meaning you don't have to reapply and you only have to apply a tiny dab to get you through an entire day and into day number 2.
So we're body care for people who care about what they put on their body and into the environment. We have pronounceable ingredients. We tread lightly on the planet, and that's who use our product, is people who are health conscious and also want to minimize their environmental impact. Come on board, join the movement. You're going to feel confident enough to be victorious every day.
Yeah.
Welcome to the stage.
Fuck yeah.
All right, we got a
stage.
We got everybody.
Yes, we got a working comedian out here, and he's been kind enough to come on down to Live from Akron and do a 2-minute slap for us. And give it up for Andrew Burge.
Go me. Oh my goodness, you guys. As a kid, I was really into arts and crafts because I liked eating glue. As an adult, I'm really into arts and crafts because I like eating glue. My doctor was like, Andrew, you gotta stop eating so much glue. I was like, but it makes my poop sticky. Oh my goodness, you guys. Oh my goodness, I'm an animal lover. My favorite animal is the chimpanzee. A chimpanzee could murder someone with its feet if you gave it a gun. That's what it would look like. Hendoh, you're dead now. Sorry. Anyway, this is a joke my chimpanzee friend taught me. Don't get that joke. I'm glad you're laughing, Morgan, because like it makes no sense to me. All right, that's my jokes.
Right.
So how long have you been doing comedy?
Oh, I've been doing like 6 months of stand-up and about 4 years of improv.
Andy Burge, everybody.
Yeah.
Not running to Andrew. We ran into each other.
Yeah.
All over Northeast Ohio doing open mics. And he's got an improv show now, right? Is that,
yeah.
What's the name of that show?
So the comedy troupe is called Brain Farts Royale. And we do, we're doing a monthly show at Crackpots in Maslin. And we're starting up a monthly show at Patina Arts Center in Canton. So it's all sort of taking off for us. We're trying to build those shows. You can catch us on Facebook. We're at Brain Farts Royale.
So that's a show, that's an improv show.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I've never been to one of those. What goes on, and what does it look like?
So it looks like, if you've seen Whose Line Is It Anyway, it's sort of like that. There's a group of us. We get suggestions from the audience, so there's a bit of audience participation, and we'll act out scenes, and we'll make jokes. There's a lot of... banter back and forth between the comedians. We're all kind of good friends, and so we all kind of bust each other's chops. It's pretty fun.
So the audience will give you some topics, and then you guys
sure.
kind of go around that and kind of improvise and,
yep.
and go from there.
Yep.
It's pretty tough to do, actually, you know. Especially you gotta get up here and tell jokes.
Mm-hmm.
Then you gotta do that same thing while trying to transition into different, you know, arenas as far as topics. That's a good thing to do. I would love to try that one. I would love to try that improv and get into that. Yeah.
Definitely.
It's good stuff, man. Like,
yeah, Hendoh, I mean, I love your comedy. Like, whenever I bump into you, I'm like, I know that's going to be a good set.
Do you like Highland Square? Do you got anything good to say about Highland Square?
I've got all the good things to say about Highland Square. Like, it's the only place I can, like, get drunk and watch a movie at the same time. I don't remember seeing the last Star Wars movie, not because I didn't see it, but because I was, like, blackout drunk.
Yeah, dude, the theater, it's always $5. It's
yeah.
incredible. And they have the China White
Lounge.
Hell yeah. You think I've never been in there yet? I still haven't been in there.
Oh, really?
I haven't been in there. $5? I didn't know it was $5.
Wow.
Well, it's because all the movies suck now. Like, if there was a good movie, you'd be there in there every day, you know?
Is that a reference to cocaine? China White Lounge?
I don't know.
Heroin.
I don't do a lot of
China
cocaine.
White with heroin, I think.
Heroin?
That's heroin.
I don't do a lot of cocaine or heroin. I do a little bit, but like not enough to know all the names.
I'm surprised you live in Highland Square.
I just know that's the name of it. I don't know why they call it that. No experience with heroin at all.
Yeah, I dabbled.
I used to walk through like opium fields and Henderson. That's about it. That's as close as I got to heroin, man.
It's right to the source, so
yeah, did anyone? You're closer than any of us.
Yeah, true.
I mean, so also with those poppies, like how do you turn that in? And you probably just gotta heat it up a little bit, right?
I have no idea. I literally know what
you boil it. You ever try boiling a poppy?
I call up my buddy and we're in Afghanistan. Close, that's all I can do for you, man. I don't know how to do that shit.
Just put between the cheek and gum, bro. I'll be out there in the field just with a trough full of poppy, bro. I'm just like, let me get that buzz, dog.
Just nothing done to it.
Right. What's your longest set that you've done? Either non-paid show or paid show or whatever?
I can do a solid 15. Like, I've got a 10-minute set coming up that but they asked me to work like clean, so like I gotta take out all my like domestic violence jokes, which you know cost me about 5 minutes, you know.
I hate when that happens. I know, I really hate what happens when you get there and didn't know it's a clean comedy set. Yeah. Like, what the fuck? And now I gotta go and like change the whole damn routine.
Well, cool. We're going to keep it moving. Andrew Burge.
Thanks, guys.
Give it up. Andrew Burge. Thank you so much, Andrew, for coming out and helping to keep the show on the road and on the stage.
Where did that guy come from?
All right. We got Chelsea coming up. And what's exciting is, you know, she's a dancer, but she said she does sing. And it turns out, luckily, Coverboy just happened to be here tonight. And
yeah,
so they have worked out a performance, they have worked out a song that they can do together.
We did.
Oh.
Chelsea, where do you
let's
want?
See.
There's a lot of chords.
Chelsea Shump, everybody.
Way to go.
Yeah, very good, very good. I'll shut that guitar down for you if you need.
need to unplug it. There you go. Oh, thanks, Chelsea. Wow, that was what a voice you got.
Nice voice.
Thanks.
Goodness gracious.
I grew it myself.
Hell yeah.
Now, did you show up for the podcast in particular, or you just walk in and
I
this just happened to be happening?
I was invited.
All right, cool. Well, thanks for coming.
Thanks for having me.
I met Chelsea a couple years ago at Frank's. She was like in her second trimester working behind the wet bar back there, and it was a karaoke night at Frank's, and she was singing and making drinks while in her second trimester, pregnant.
Okay.
And serving, singing, walking around serving other customers and dropping off food and drinks and still singing the song. Didn't even have to look up at the screen. Amazing. Never seen anything like it before. I've never seen anything like that.
Never will again.
She's trying to train that baby so when she pops it out, it can know how to serve her.
Oh, no, we're done, sir.
That baby is tending bar right now.
He's busy.
He's busy.
What's this, our next topic?
Yeah. Well, I wanted to say that, Hendoh said you're a dancer.
Correct.
What kind of dancing do you do?
I am a tap dancer by trade, and I was at a professional modern dance company, a couple of modern dance companies for 8 years. I did my time, and I've been working at dance studios for 15 years, and things kind of came to a head. With the dance industry and the entertainment industry in general, there's a lot of like unearthing going on and some really nasty, nasty things happening to children and adults alike. But
wait, what was it? Unearthing?
Unearthing of like some really nasty things that go on in the entertainment industry, particularly the
things
dance
were
industry.
Bubbling up to the surface.
Yes,
from the underbelly.
Like,
that
there's
dark.
Things that people didn't know or things that have been like pressed down and not talked about, like. Sex crimes, namely.
Oh my God! Yeah,
yeah.
Because like, yeah, I can imagine. You know, sometimes, you know, like the swimmers, for example.
Yeah.
Remember,
yeah,
there
similar.
Was how many hundreds of swimmers were molested by some freak show doctor guy.
Gymnasts.
Like, I'll take care of these little gymnasts. Oh, how scary! So you were connected to some nasty
yes.
stuff.
Yes, I was not a victim, but some of my students were, and former students of mine were victims of something similar. It's all the same coin. So what I did was I started a business. So I now I'm a legal business owner, and I run a dance studio.
Wow,
yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. Wow, good.
Yeah,
that's amazing.
Thank you. Yeah, so where is
this
at? It's in Green. It's called the Jive Hive LLC.
The Jive Hive.
Uh-huh.
Wow.
Yep. And everything's accessible on the cell phone, so you can register classes. It's open ages. We do a lot of like pop-up open classes. So if you ever wanted to try something, like it's affordable and it's available. All my teachers are highly vetted.
Well, with a name like that, do you get a lot of those octogenarians? Like,
what is that word?
Like elderly women trying to jive?
No,
is like, is,
I don't.
Is jive?
They can come, but I haven't had that. It's mostly teenagers. I generally my.
Because when you think of jive, you think of like the 30s or 40s.
Good.
I don't know why.
Good.
Is that a thing? Did they used to,
I don't know.
Was the jive popular? Is it still popular?
I don't know what that is, but it's like another term for like a fun dance.
Okay, it's also, they put that in the word in front of a turkey sometimes.
I'm not doing that, but.
What is that referring to when they say jive turkey?
I'm not getting into it.
They're referring to you. That's
they're talking about you. They're talking about you, David.
That's what they're talking about.
Yeah, so that's
no matter what, no matter how close it is to Thanksgiving, it doesn't matter.
I'm tripping on this jive, bro. No, listen, I'm juking and jiving. I mean, come on. You know,
it's one way to put it.
I want
to
see the jive hustle. That's the dance they used to do. Jive hustle.
Sure.
He takes more away from Juneteenth. Juneteenth is just coming. I'm still high from Juneteenth, man. I had to get a bastard that up in fucking Old Brooklyn yesterday. He wanted to talk shit about fucking Juneteenth and Oprah eating fucking watermelon and all this trash. And I had to go and get him, man. I had to get him, man.
Wait, what's going on? There's some sort of dispute?
Yeah, just some knuckle.
Somebody busting your balls?
Just some jive turkey.
Jive. Doing the jive hustle on the corner.
Yeah, Chelsea's very, very talented. She's very multifaceted and different dances. And she can dance. I know her toes hooked up.
I've seen the video.
She's really good. I'm actually kind of assigning my daughter in for her classes when she comes up. Yeah.
Do you think you could? She says she can hardly break dance. I mean, can you? Do you think you could break dance better?
I'm 45, man. I did my break dancing days, man. I can't do that.
Well, you know, when I got two break dancers on the stage, you know what we do.
Trying to do a versus of that over here.
Give us a shoulder roll or something.
Too much bass.
No such thing.
How can I be at it again if I ain't never stop? Oh, you say you red hot, but it is in a red hot. I ain't had a thorn shoes, I'm flip, but I never stop. Well, you spin that pole.
The white boys are back. I don't know where you never be went. The white boys are back.
Y'all love children?
I don't beatbox like a white boy, do I?
That was pretty good, actually.
Don't be offending me, Hendoh.
Where's Jesus? Josh? None of you are Josh.
Well, I was doing that until one of y'all break dance. That's okay. You got any parachute pants, Chelsea?
No, fresh out.
Wait a minute.
Oh, this is a cat suit, boy.
What do you call that?
A cat suit.
That's pretty close. It's in the same genre. It's in the same ballpark.
Cat suit.
You got the Hammer boots, but not the pants.
I got holes in these boots.
No, MC Hammer used to wear those, you know, his dancers wore the boots.
Oh my gosh.
I found out those boots are gay, though.
What boots? Those?
Doc Martens.
Doc Martens?
Yeah. Did you know they were gay? But then it occurred to me, yeah, they are gay, actually. I mean, I'm not calling you gay, and I'm actually a straight man.
Whatever, it have been called worse.
So you just called your own shoes gay.
Somebody.
And then called me gay.
My friend's daughter.
They kept the shoes.
I do like them. They kept the shoes.
Their mother cost a lot of money, didn't they? Yeah.
Listen, my friend's daughter is 13, and she's the one who told me that they're gay. Mm. So, I'm like, busted.
Damn shame.
I'm all about saving money, too. So keep them.
Well, Chelsea, you know, that was a sensational performance. Thank you for getting up here.
Thank you guys for having me. I hope you come back
when your foot's healed up. And
I
won't force you to do break dancing if that's
outside.
You're
not forcing to do shit.
There will be part of
it. I will, but I might.
But I love you, Dad.
Well, I might try to hypnotize you just a little bit.
Won't work.
No, you don't think?
No.
We shall see, Chelsea. Hey, Chelsea! Right, Chelsea, get up, Chelsea. Chelsea Shump.
Totally.
Who else do we got out here? Kyle, you want to come up and do 2 minutes?
Kyle!
And then we're gonna have Jack Windsor after Kyle. And then that's probably going to be it for tonight.
All right.
Yeah. Keep it short and sweet.
Thanks. Go, Kyle, go.
Go, Kyle, go.
All right. Kyle Robert Brace, cover boy.
Welcome back to the stage.
Also known as Killed Cowboy. All right, give it up 2 minutes for the Killed Cowboy. All right, I got your guitar.
All right,
uninterrupted.
This song is called Killed Cowboy. It's by indie artist Kevin Crowder. And,
that an original?
No, that is a cover. it's an artist. Her name is Kevin Crowder. This is an older song, maybe 2018, 2016, but I don't know, it's just like an indie rock song I like, and I wrote the, well, it's kind of picking, and I kind of made like a little finger picking part, and you know, I just think.
Like a remix.
Yeah, it's kind of a little remix, you know.
Like a reinterpretation with the little finger style arrangement.
Yeah. But,
wow.
Do you write your own material as well?
I do, yeah. Not usually that good, but I was feeling that song because there's something, yeah, maybe it's, I did smoke some weed and I was thinking about my life and how sometimes like you can have a really good night that's kind of, you know, it's like a past trauma or whatever. I'm not gonna get into specifics of my life, but where it's kind of like, oh, you're trying to be there, but then something like pops into your head, or it makes you think about things, or loss, or whatever, and it kind of, you know, you kind of put a little damper. It's like you can't allow yourself to have a good time on some occasions, depending, but I don't know. Yeah, it's a lot. Sorry, but that's why I'm playing the song.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, and sorry, you guys are, you know.
Yeah, you're so deep about it, and all I could think of was I could bang a chick to that.
Well, yeah.
Alright, Dave. Man. We just had a nice high moment right before that, and it was just like, now it's down.
No, let's get
it. We gotta bring it back down to planet Earth.
Yeah, come back to Earth, right. It's...
So do you play around town at all, or mostly open mics?
I'm trying to get a band together, but like open mics. And I wanted to talk to you, Jack. I saw you out at Jinx a couple weeks ago for the... Your singer-songwriter,
The
song swap, and I loved your material, and I love that you did this charming man tonight, you know, and like knowing your story a little bit, and it's kind of close to my heart, and I do more see at like kind of like country bumpkin karaoke's, because it's like. Yeah, fuck you, like, gay people exist, go fuck yourself, you know what I mean? Like, and I know that you can play to those crowds sometimes, and like, to see you play that kind of song where it's, it delves deeper into the human experience than any type of sexual identity or preference, you know? And it's kind of like, the bigotedness of most of America is just, people need to be exposed to stuff like that. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean,
I don't know if that was your intention at all. I just sounded like that song.
I mean, my intention was people just tell me I sound like Morrissey all the time, so I was pandering to them. Just like, I'll throw you this one.
No way! People say you sound like Morrissey?
Constantly.
No way!
I don't know. I listened to Smith a bit when I was first figuring out how to write songs, and
I love
our styles just.
Johnny Marr is one of my favorite guitar players. Like, oh my gosh. Yeah, you're a great finger player. Like,
thanks. Appreciate it.
Much better.
Would you want to do a spot of the song swap one of these times?
I don't know if I'm prolific enough to write properly enough.
Shut up. No, yeah, it's one you are. You play really well. You got a good voice.
He's got all the originals. He's got all the covers. So
I'll do one day for sure. Yeah.
I mean,
it's one of the best open micers I've ever heard,
dude.
I think you just did was like amazing, dude. Amazing. That's but you always do that every time I see you. So
I practice. You know what I mean? It's like I just hope the fuck I'm in the zone. It's all about being in the zone. It's like any other,
Dude.
Sometimes you I fucked up, you know.
Me and Kyle.
It's okay, you just have to jump back in, you know.
Bro, you've given me so much love through the years, dude. When I'm out there just thinking to myself, I am a piece of trash, throw me in the dumpster, coming off a stage.
Yes, sir.
And this dude's like, dude, that was awesome. God damn, Kyle.
And we're all like artists, and I, you know, that in itself, it, all of you guys go out and perform and you give back, you know, is what makes all this shit worth it. You know, it really does, you know, making people laugh, giving them joy, having some actual guitar every once in a while in a public space where it's a human being doing something. It's not just, you know, the nothingness of, I mean, I love records, but it's dead music. It's just, it's like a museum. You just experience it. And it's
cool. Dude, how much magic happens when you know, just out of nowhere.
Exactly.
Boom,
yeah.
There's a nugget of magic and it bursts open and you're on a different dimension for like, a while.
Yeah, and like, comedians, you guys are writers, you know, you write, you know?
I mean, dude, it's incredible. Well, OG open micer, Highland Square, original gangster right here, Kyle Robert Brace, Cowboy, Killer Cowboy, everybody. Hell yeah. Thanks for everything, Kyle. Thank you so much.
We'll get in touch and we'll figure out a date for you to come to the song swap, right?
Yeah, much love, hell yeah.
Yeah, dude. So thank you guys for coming out once again. Andrew Burge is still here. Thank you, sir, for contributing. Really appreciate you. Morgan, John, Chase, thank you so much. And Kyle and Hendoh, thank you, bro.
Yeah.
You know, for just like putting a lot of effort into, you know, making this podcast, this live podcast, get off the ground.
Cool. Well, I guess we were kind of talking about when you feel bad getting off stage and someone comes and says, hey man, that was really good. But you know it wasn't. We're pretty damn self-aware artists, I think. Probably the biggest downfall of the whole thing, being a little too self-aware. But I had a couple of those shows. Well, no one came up and said, hey man, that was real good. I knew I messed up. I let the nerves get to me, so I was wallowing for a bit. You can wallow for a minute, but you gotta keep going back out. And I wrote this song while I was wallowing about, you know, giving this whole thing up. You know, that's like, I'm just gonna quit this shit. But so I came up with a song, I call it Son of a Bitch.
Since you left. train that I met a long time ago. Well, son of a bitch, I'm cashing in my chips. I'm paying off my bar tab. I'm leaving a real nice tip. Those days have turned to years since everything about you disappeared. I just wish I could see a way out.
See you again next week.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.